Hey, are you confused about the psychology and the thought process of a real winner? Are you still thinking how to be a winner, especially in this current very trying, very difficult, unforeseen situations that we face day to day? Well, look no further. Look no further than the pep talk. This entire week, me, your friend, your guide, your mentor, your trainer, Captain Nag, Brother Nag, Mr. Nag, Sudeep Nag, I am going to celebrate the motivational week, starting with today's video. So look no further for those answers. Without wasting any more time, let me start giving you 5 important points that will help you to develop a winner's psychology. First point, overcoming frustrations. You must be feeling a lot of frustrations in life at times. Current situation, lots of fear, layoffs, lack of jobs, lack of money, lack of funds, lack of opportunities. Honor your struggle. Friends, honor your struggle. Let me repeat, honor your struggle. Do not see it as a negativity, a frustration. Honor it. Think that this is an opportunity for you. It presents a real struggle where you have an opportunity to come out as a winner. That's how a winner would think. Balance between happiness and frustration is very important. Too much of happiness is complacency. Too much of frustration is stress. We need to find a balance. Point number 2, manage rejections. When you talk of success, when you talk of selection, when you talk of climbing the ladder, understand rejection comes along with it. It's a part of life. It's a pain in the mind when you are rejected. But trust me, friends, trust me. More number of rejections give you more number of chances to succeed. Get ready to hear no's. The more number of no's that you hear, the more number of yeses you are getting close to. So the secret of mass acceptance is mass rejection. Let's move to point number 3, coming out of the comfort zone. Friends, comfort zone is your enemy. It's an enemy of your abilities, your skills, and your dreams. Success can bring complacency. So comfort zone is like a prison, a trap, a matrix that you get into. Jump in faith is something you need to do. Jumping in faith where there is no guarantee of success, coming out of that comfort zone, that, my friend, is a guarantee of success. Point number 4, overpowering failures. Winners know how to overpower failures. Failure is a resting ground, not a nesting ground. Let me repeat, failure is a resting ground, not a nesting ground. Increase your failure to get more success, like tossing a coin and trying to get a tail. If you want 5 tails, you toss 10 times, 15 times, then you get 5. But remember, yes, you met your target, but you also got 10 heads. That means 10 failures. So next time you want 10 heads, you need to toss 30 times and get ready for 20 failures, 20 tails. So if you think that failure doesn't come when you are on a path of success, you are in a hallucination, right? It is a prerequisite for success. If you want to succeed, you have to fail. Remember, if you want to succeed faster, double your failure rate. Let me repeat, if you want to succeed faster, double your failure rate. Point number 5, and the final point, handling pressure. Lack of time, lack of opportunity, lack of funds, lack of jobs, insecurities, uncertainties, client wants quality, competition, lack of customers, you're stressed out. But a winner will know how to handle this pressure. Just like Michael Phelps, the famous American swimmer, whose coach would put his clock in a wrong timing or would give him faulty glasses while practicing so that he is prepared for the worst unknown scenario. So winners never quit and quitters never win. Winners never quit and quitters never win. When you think of a winner, you think, oh, this guy is successful, he's got a lot of money, a great job, a great car, a great house, a great business. No. A winner doesn't think that way. Winner doesn't see the outcome and think that this is success. Winner gets up from his bed every day morning. Listen to me, friends, very carefully. Listen once again. Winner gets up from his bed every day morning, fights the fight, fights the failure, fights the frustration, fights the uncomfortable situation, fights the uncertainty. He doesn't think of the outcome. He gives it a fight. Fight the fight. He lives to fight. So, only thing that changes in life, and that will change, your life will change, your mentality of a winner's mentality will come in when you raise your bar, when you raise your standards more and more and ask more from yourself. And do not ask, why me? Listen to me carefully, friends. Do not ask, why me? Look eye to eye and ask, try me. Let me repeat, do not ask, why me? Look eye to eye and ask, try me. I hope, friends, this video was very interesting, very helpful. And thank you so much for watching this video. Keep watching all the videos, especially this week. We are celebrating a motivational week on the pep talk. And your friend, your dost, your host, your trainer, your mentor, Mr. Nag, Sudeep Nag, Brother Nag, is going to be back with very, very useful, positive boosters, motivations and attitude to succeed, especially what we are going through right now and also in the future. So signing off, have a great day, take good care of yourself, and always, always smile.